Selena Gomez drops I Want You to Know single featuring Zedd.
Rihanna's 27th birthday party was epic, and we've got the details.
And we also have everything you need to know from the 87th annual Oscars.
All that and more on today's Hollywood Rundown.
Hey, you guys, welcome back to the Daily Hollywood Rundown with Erin Robinson and Danielle Robay. It's a very special trophy live show. It's jam-packed, so we're gonna get started right now with the Oscars.
And what would the Oscars be without the fashion? And I'm gonna kick it off with my number one best dress, Zoe Saldana.
Oh.
She looked beautiful. She was wearing a blush-colored Versace gown, and it hugged her curves. She gave birth to twins 2 months ago, and she looked so gorgeous. She had her hair in a low, messy bun.
Yeah.
I loved it.
Someone else who kind of wore that blush nude color was Jennifer Lopez. My gosh, this woman was gorgeous, and Ellie Saab, my best dress pick of the night.
Well, moving on, Emma Stone wore a custom beaded chartreuse Ellie Saab gown. A lot of Ellie Saab going on, and it was cool. I know she was best dressed for a lot of people. She wasn't my favorite.
I love the color on her, and I just love that she can wear pretty much anything. She's so confident. I just think it's her confidence that she wears.
Yes.
Somebody else who's really confident and sexy tonight was Jennifer Aniston. Oh my gosh, Jens? There's something about that name that makes you flawless.
And speaking of Jens, Jennifer Hudson looked flawless in a figure-hugging yellow Ramona Cavizza dress, and she had her hair in a side part, a pink lip. She looked great.
Looked great. Somebody who was very controversial on the carpet was Lady Gaga. She showed up looking very Gaga in this white dress with some silver metallic beading on it. It's by a Paris designer named Azzedine Alia. It was really couture looking. It was very Gaga. Not a lot of people liked it because the gloves, the red gardener gloves, threw it off.
I loved it. Did you like it?
I liked it. I just didn't like the gloves. I could do without the gloves, but everything else I thought was cool.
Oscars are about like major glam moments. I thought she was glam.
Yeah.
And also glam was Anna Kendrick, who a lot of people said stole the show because her dress was actually trending on Twitter. It was a coral dress with crystal embellished keyhole neckline. And I don't know, it was cool. It was a relatively new designer.
I think this is the case of the girl wearing the dress, not the dress wearing the girl. And I think Anna Kendrick, anything that she wears is gonna be trending. Okay, so obviously it's the Oscars. A lot of people won Oscars tonight, and we're gonna run through some winners really quickly. First of all, Whiplash, amazing movie. It won several awards throughout the night, kind of a sleeper hit. They won for sound mixing, film editing. J.K. Simmons won for best supporting actor for playing that psycho drill sergeant jazz instructor in the movie. He was awesome. Selma won in the category for original song for Glory, which was written by John Legend and Common. American Sniper won for best sound editing, which was probably due to the fact that it's hard to make war sound realistic in film, so well deserved. Still, Alice got some major recognition when Julianne Moore won for best actress. Boyhood, which was a huge front runner to win a bunch of categories tonight, didn't really take home much from the show, but Patricia Arquette did win for best actress in a supporting role. The Imitation Game, which was one of my favorite films of the awards season, won for adapted screenplay, also well-deserved. Big Hero 6, oh my gosh, such a great movie, so adorable. It won for best animated film. Not surprisingly, Birdman soared tonight, winning a ton of big categories for best director, best original screenplay, cinematography, and for best picture, which is obviously the biggest prize of the night. But Michael Keaton, who was in Birdman, surprisingly didn't win an Oscar for best actor, which everyone thought he would. Instead, that went to Eddie Redmayne, and his speech was amazing, and he's adorable, and I'm so happy.
This Oscar. Wow.
And speaking of Eddie Redmayne, I'm gonna count down some of the best moments of the Oscars, and he's one of them. His speech was awesome. He was so humbled, and he said that his Oscar belongs to all the people around the world battling ALS, and he will be its custodian. So that was a beautiful moment.
He was so excited.
Another great moment was when Chris Pine shed a tear during Glory, which is from the movie Selma. Common and John Legend performed. The whole audience was really emotional, but we saw Chris Pine shed a tear, which was it was unexpected.
I love it when hot guys cry.
Speaking of crying, I almost cried during Lady Gaga's The Sound of Music tribute.
I did cry.
It was the special 50th anniversary, and she performed a beautiful medley of the songs from The Sound of Music. And then the best moment was at the end when Julie Andrews came up and gave her a big hug, and before she announced the next winner, she was like, that meant so much to me. So that was cool. Another funny moment was Kevin Hart and Anna Kendrick. They presented an award together and were making jokes about how short they were. That was pretty awesome. I could be on stage with them, 5'1". And Idina Menzel and John Travolta also presented an award. And this was funny because last year Travolta really botched Idina Menzel's name, calling her Adele Dazeem, which she will never live down, but they kind of made fun of the moment this year. And how can we mention funny without talking about Neil Patrick Harris? The host opened his monologue, which was hilarious, and he did it in his best way, he sang. And he was joined by Anna Kendrick and then by Jack Black, which was hilarious. It was planned, but it didn't seem like it from the audience. Another Neil Patrick Harris moment was when he was making fun of Birdman and came up on stage in his underwear. That was like, that image will never leave my mind. That was hilarious.
Well, have you seen Gone Girl? If you haven't, don't, because that will definitely ruin it for you.
And then we got to see all of these celebs get Oscars that didn't actually win Oscars because there was a performance of Everything is Awesome from the Lego Movie, and they gave Channing Tatum, Emma Stone, Steve Carell, and Oprah Lego Oscars.
Which is better than the real Oscar, let's be real.
It was pretty great seeing Oprah hold her Lego Oscar, I have to say.
Keeping our Oscars coverage going, Zedd was at the Oscars tonight. Sans Selena Gomez, but you know what? She didn't need to go to the Oscars because she's making headlines.
So, like Aaron said, Zedd was at the Oscars tonight. He was sitting next to his friend Jared Leto. His song, I Want You to Know, which is his first single off of his second album that's coming out with Selena Gomez, dropped tonight.
Big news.
Big news. Hit the internet, and they actually filmed a music video for it on February 8th in LA, but that hasn't come out yet.
Which I was shocked by.
Right, but we did see Selena post an Instagram photo that Aaron and I think is from the music video because it has this 70s, 80s vibe that we heard the music video is about.
Let's listen to a clip of that song. I want you to know that it's our time. You and me bleed the same light. I want you to know. Danielle, what do you think? Do you like this?
I don't love it. I think the beat is awesome. Zedd is super talented. And I like Selena. I don't like her voice on this track.
Interesting. I really like the song. I thought it was a super upbeat. I think it's going to be a huge hit this summer. I think everybody's going to be listening to it in the club. I won't be listening to it at home because I don't do the club. But I still like the song a lot.
Speaking of in the club,
okay.
Riri was in the club for a very special birthday.
Yeah, Riri celebrated her 27th birthday this weekend, you guys, in a birthday bash that was thrown by Leonardo DiCaprio. Oh, yes. The rumors are true. These two were hanging out at a house party in LA, but you wouldn't know it was a house party because it looked like a club up in there. It was at this businessman's house named Jim Goldstein in Beverly Hills. And the guest list for this party was out of control. It was Beyonce, it was Jay-Z, it was the Hilton sisters, Jim Carrey, Bill Murray, and Mick Jagger, just to name a few. You're missing a couple names, Danielle Robay and Aaron Robinson, but that's okay, girl, next year. Here are a couple of things that we do know about the party. First of all, there are tons of balloons there, as you would expect, but balloons that spelled out Rihanna's name, because why not? She's Rihanna. Also, Rihanna was dressed in this slinky, sexy, cleavage-bearing, sparkling silver dress. She looked like a trophy. Hello, keeping the Oscars theme going. She also was presented with a 3-tiered leopard print and marijuana themed birthday cake.
That is so out of control.
I wonder if there was pot in the cake. I'm pretty sure there probably was. And apparently, sources close to E! News are saying that Leonardo and Rihanna spent a lot of the night dancing together, kissing, flirting, smooching, that they weren't too heavily into each other, but they were flirting just enough to solidify the fact that they probably are dating. All right, it wouldn't be a Monday without it being messy. So it's time to get messy on this Mess Up Monday.
A lot of funny moments. Also, speaking of funny moments, that was one.
I love that we just laugh and comb our hair.
Leave it to normal.
I'm not coordinated.
See, what you're supposed to have in your hand is actually a paintbrush. Do the hump to hump.
Oh, I see.
Do the hump to hump.
Oh. bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?
You took it on this one.
And you took it on that one. You took it on your mother and you took it on your father.
All right, you guys, it's time to hear your thoughts. Danielle and I are like real tired, so let us know in the comments, what was your favorite moment from the Oscars? Was it the red carpet? Was it the acceptance speeches, the winners? Which one?
And also tell us what you think of Zedd and Selena's new song. Aaron and I have different opinions, so we want to know what you think.
I like it. Cheer me on in the comments, you guys. Thanks for watching the Daily Hollywood Rundown with Danielle Rabay and Aaron Robinson, and we'll see you tomorrow. Speaking of award shows, you guys, the Kids' Choice Awards are right around the corner, and we have all the nominations in that video box on the left. And to find out why Iggy Azalea quit Twitter and Instagram, it's true, click in the video box on the right for that craziness. Do it. Click it. Push that button. Push it.